In this video segment, we'll take a look at how to create kitchen islands. The same process will work for bath vanities and other cabinet combinations. I'll look at the process to block and unblock islands, how to add them to your library, and how you can create island options and replace them in a plan and present those options for your clients. And finally, how to create elevation dimensions for your islands. Let's start the process by placing a couple of cabinets that can be used for an island. I'll begin the process by using the base cabinet tool, and I'm going to place just a couple of cabinets that could be used to begin an island. As you can imagine, you could extend that out to any configuration of cabinets as I have on the right hand side of the screen. And when you have that configuration of cabinets and you want to save it into your library, you can block these items and save them in. Let's take a look at the two cabinets we created. I'm going to hold my shift key down and drag a marquee around the two cabinets. When they're both selected, you'll find an option down in your lower edit menu to make an architectural block. Once those items are blocked, you can then use the Add to Library button right next to it and add those components to your library. When they're added into the library, it comes in as a nondescript untitled option. You can always right click on this and rename it and give it a good name. In this case, we'll just call it Temp Island. And now you can organize it and place it where you want to. One of the reasons you may want to add this into your library is to create a portfolio that you can use for future designs. In my personal library, if I scroll up a little bit, I've created a folder for islands and vanities. These are islands that can be used for future designs. I also have an option of A, B, and C that I'm going to show you how you can replace these islands. And these are islands that you may reuse in the future, unblock them, and adapt them to new designs. And we'll talk about that a little bit more here in the video. When you block an island and save it into your library, you can save more than just the cabinets. If I switch over to the 3D view and take a look at this broader island that I have, you'll see that I have furniture with the stools, I have accessories along with the cabinets and a custom countertop. All of these items can be blocked and saved into your library. The best way to do that is when you're in your plan view, make sure that you turn on the layers that you want to block. Currently, I'm using a plan view called Floor Plan Shell that only shows basic things. It's related to the layer set. Let me switch this over to my working view, which also switches the layer set to the working layer set. And in this case, you can see my electrical components, you can see my accessories. And to create that block, it would be the same as we did on these two simple cabinets. Hold my shift key down, draw a marquee around these components. The larger island that I have selected, notice there is no Make Architectural Block available in the lower edit menu. There are some components that are not allowed to exist in an architectural block. One of them is a camera. Any of your elevation camera or perspective cameras cannot be blocked. And typically some CAD objects cannot be blocked. In this case, if I press the space bar, there's a couple of things that cannot be blocked. Let's go ahead and open up our active layer display. And one of those is going to be the electrical circuit. So I'm going to come in here, turn off the electrical circuit. The other item that cannot be included in an architectural block is the electrical rope light or the electrical LED strip. For the LED strip light, I'll have to assign that to a new layer. I'll double click and open it up. And on the layer panel, I'm going to come over and click define. Currently it's on the electrical layer. I'll make a copy of this and we'll put it on a electrical LED. Make sure to turn that layer off. And now when I close the dialogs, I can come back in, draw a marquee around the island, being careful not to get the camera for the elevation, and now the block appears. So it may require a little bit of work to create a block and turn the layers on and off that you're allowed to block. Now before I proceed and make an architectural block out of this island, I want to mention a word of caution. Notice that I have an elevation camera, and if I were to open this up, you're going to see that I have dimensions, as well as if I have dimensions on the floor plan. When you create an architectural block, you will lose your dimensions. Since it converts the object to one singular object, all of the dimensions that are going to the individual objects, in this case the cabinet, the countertops, all of those dimensions would be lost. Here's what I would recommend. Make this the last step that you do. Save your plan if you have dimensions. Save the plan, then create an architectural block, add it to your library, and then close your plan without saving it. That way you can recover. As soon as I tile my screens and I go back in and I create an architectural block out of this, take a look at what happens when I block this to the dimensions on the left-hand side of my screen. You will lose those dimensions. So just be aware that does happen, and as I recommended, maybe make that the last operation you do and don't save it into your plan. Now, with the architectural block created before I add this to the library, one of the things that I like to do is open up the architectural block, and on the general panel, I typically like to suppress the bounding box that you see surrounding it. The sub-objects are all the components that make up the architectural block. If you want to suppress that, you can do that by removing the check mark. Once I've removed the bounding box, I'm going to come down and add that into my library. And just like the couple of simple cabinets we started with in the beginning of the design, it comes in with an untitled, give it a good name. If you're going to be creating several islands and building up a portfolio, I like to build a folder, and in that case you can cut and paste this. I've already created the folder, so if I cut this, scroll up to my islands folder, open that folder up, and on my completed islands, I could then simply right-click, paste that island in, and now it's available as one of the islands. When you have islands in your library, you can use a Replace from Library feature and create options for your clients. You take a look at the images that I have on the screen. I have three different options that the client can choose from, and I place the island into the scene. Let's take a look at how you can use the Replace from Library and swap out a library object such as this island. As I return back into the plan with the island, I'll select the island. It's a block. In my lower edit menu, you're going to find an option that says Replace from Library. There's a few options that you can choose from. Replace the selected object. You may have some other options if you're swapping out stools or pendant lights that you can choose one of the other options down here. I'll choose the library button, and now I can choose which object to replace it with. In the bonus catalog that is provided with Chief Architect that you can download from the 3D library, you're going to find islands in here. They're grouped islands, and you can choose from a handful of islands in here. In my case, I've created some islands that I prefer to use in my portfolio underneath my user catalog, which was the same view that we were looking at previously. I'm going to come down into my custom cabinets and islands, into my completed islands, and then I'll just swap out the island in this case. We'll choose this bright opened island. You see a preview of it. It's pretty small. Go ahead and select OK. Notice in the dialog it's updated with the object name, and then you can press OK to accept that change. The entire island is replaced. I've saved a camera view of that island. If I go back in and open it up in my project browser, you can see the new island. The same feature works in this mode. Select the island, come down and choose the Replace from Library. Same dialog comes up. And I'll come back down to my personal folder for islands, choose the new island I want to replace it with. Again, it tells you which island you're choosing, and then it will swap it out. And in the 3D view, you can see the new island. Replace from Library can be a powerful feature. Again, remember if you've done any dimensioning in your plan view or in your elevation views, those dimensions will disappear when you create an object out of those islands. So typically use this for your presentation options and do the save operation before blocking it and putting it into your library. Now the last thing I want to talk about is how to dimension your islands. I'm going to open up a sample plan that has an island in it, and we'll talk about how to isolate your dimensions for your island. I've opened up the sample plan for the Stone Creek Kitchen. The plan view, as you can see on the right-hand side, and the elevation view on the left-hand side, I've been able to isolate the island. You don't see any of the platforms for the ceiling, and you also don't see the wall behind the island. Let's talk about how to best do that. With your elevation cameras, you're going to find a couple of different elevation cameras. The back clip section camera will create a slice through your design. Let's go ahead and take a slice through this island. So I'm just going to draw the back clip from the back of the island to the front of the island. When the elevation generates, you're going to see the platform information. In this case, I may not have a roof or a ceiling in this sample plan, but you do see the thickness for the floor information in the ceiling. And if I did have a complete floor platform, you would see that, as well as the wall information on the sides. And that's the back clip section view. It will show you the entire view of the plan. If you have a larger plan, it'll show you the adjacent rooms next to it. Now, the view that I like to use a lot of times is a wall elevation view. You'll find that underneath your elevation cameras. The wall elevation is meant to generate a wall elevation. When I click and drag through the island and release, you will see the wall. That's why it's called a wall elevation. What you don't see are the platform components on the sides. You don't see the wall thicknesses, and on the top and the bottom, you don't see the thicknesses for the floor and the ceiling finishes. Now, if you want to isolate this and exclude the wall from being displayed, let me tile my views by pressing Shift F6 on the keyboard. The view that's been generated is this new view called E1. You can open up that camera. Notice it's selected. You can use the open key. It's found in your lower edit menu. You'll notice there's a shortcut to it. In this case, it says Control E. Click the open button in this case. In this wall elevation specification, there's an option down here underneath the camera panel to backclip after an amount. In this case, I already clicked and dragged through the island, and I'm just going to accept that amount that I did the click and drag. By enabling the back clip, watch what happens to the view. It will then crop out beyond where that back clip is. So when you create a wall elevation, open it up and mark to back clip if you want to exclude things behind where you drug that camera out. Now, the last portion of the video is to dimension the island. My dimension default is set to the NKBA dimensions. I'm going to use the manual dimension tool. I'm going to come down through the bottom portion of the island and just click and drag the dimension line. Go ahead and pull that down. Any of the dimensions you want to remove, you'll see in a diamond. Just simply pull those off. And then to run the dimension the entire length, I'm going to use the end-to-end dimension. Just click and drag through the entire run of the cabinets. Again, reposition that dimension, and that's the process of adding your dimensions to your kitchen island. Thanks for watching the video on kitchen islands.